purpose of this video is to show you how to access and use Speedgrader. So Speedgrader is where you'll go to view student submissions on Canvas. So the first thing you'll do is go into your Canvas course. You're going to go to Assignments and click on Assignments, and you'll click on the specific assignment that you want to grade. So I made this as an example, so we'll click on this assignment. As long as you're logged in as the teacher, and usually if your students have already submitted something, so at least one student has submitted work, if you look on the right-hand side of the assignment, you'll see the word Speedgrader. That's where we're going. I know you see download submission and re-upload submission here. Those are also options. I'll briefly talk about that, but I don't want that to be the focus of the video. You can always download your students' assignment submissions to your computer. You might want to do this to have them there as a backup, or if you want to go into their assignments and make specific comments, so maybe you're editing an essay. This is always an option where you could edit the essay and then re-upload it to them so that they can see specifically within that essay what they needed to change or what you liked, etc. I can do another video on this, but we're really just going to focus on Speedgrader. When I do these videos, I just kind of like to focus on one thing at a time. So again, you can still access the assignments in Speedgrader. This would be to download the assignments to your computer. So I'm going to click on Speedgrader. We'll go ahead and open that up. Excuse me while I cover up a student's name. Okay, so right now we are looking at Speedgrader. This is pretty much what it looks like. And what you're seeing here, I know it only says hello, but that's actually my student's assignment submission. So I went in as this student and just submitted the word hello so that you could see what happens when a student submits something. So when I'm in here, I'm covering the student's name. This is their assignment submission. If they had submitted anything like a file, it would show up where it says submitted files. So we're looking at the student's assignment. So as the teacher, I'm gonna grade this assignment. And again, I know it's not a lot, it's just an example. Your students might have more text here. You might have had them send you a picture of their assignment, whatever it is. So I'm looking at the student's assignment and saying, okay, they did great. I'm ready to grade it. I'm going to come over to the right-hand side. I can look at the date and time to make sure they met the deadline. And now the most important part of this, where it says assessment, grade out of 100, I'm going to enter the grade in this box. I made this assignment 100 points. You can make it as many points as you want when you create the assignment. So I'm going to give this student a 95, and if I want, I can comment saying great. Okay, so I gave the student a 95 for their work, and I commented saying great. If I wanted to attach a PDF for them, maybe to give them more information about the topic, I could always click on the paperclip. You can also attach a video or an audio, but I'm not really gonna get into this because there's not many times someone might use this. But most likely if you were gonna attach anything, it might be the answer key or a PDF. And you can do that by clicking on the paper clip where it says file attachment. So anyways, we made our comment, we put our points. After we checked the student work, and I'm covering her name, but that was the student. So I'm gonna go ahead and click submit. All right. So now we clicked submit, so this student received that grade for their assignment. So now I am gonna go to see what other students turned in the assignment. There's two ways I can do this. If you look on both sides of my thumb, you'll see little arrows. One is pointing to the right, one's pointing to the left. If you click on those, you can go through the different submissions from your students. However, if not all of your students have submitted an assignment, something like this might come up. So when I clicked on the arrow, it brought up a new student whose name I'm covering, and it said that the student did not submit the assignment. So a way that you can check just to see which students completed the assignments is by this. Next to the student's name, there'll be a check mark. If you click on that check mark, it drops down and shows you which students have completed the assignment. I'm going to cover the students' names, but it'll do that by showing you green check marks or yellow circles. Green check marks means you've graded those assignments. Yellow circles mean the assignment's been submitted, but you haven't graded it yet. So I'm going to click on another student. So look, we're looking at one student's hello assignment right now. They submitted hello. I'm going to click on a different student. Now you see another student's paper, and his paper says, how are you? So this is a different student covering his name that submitted a different assignment. So I'm going to go ahead and give this student a grade out of 100. I'm going to give him 100. And in the comments box, I'm going to say wonderful. And I'm going to hit submit. So now what's nice about Canvas is if you look in the top corner here where you see that percentage, that's actually the class average for all of the papers that I've graded. So Canvas will show you the class average. If you want to break it up into who got what percentage, if you look over here on the left-hand side, if you click on this notebook, it's your Canvas gradebook. So it looks a lot like Pinnacle or any other gradebook you might use in your county. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on it, but I'm gonna veer out for a minute so it doesn't show you any student information. Okay, so I'm covering the students' names, but you can see it shows you what grade they got for the assignment. So that was when I clicked on gradebook. So I'm gonna go back to Speedgrader. So we're back on Speedgrader, but remember, I saw that gradebook by clicking on this notebook, the gradebook. All right, so this was a really basic video on how to access Speedgrader and how you can grade assignments. There's obviously more advanced ways that you could go about this, but I try to make some beginner videos. So this is just a beginner video on how you would get into Speedgrader, how you would enter those points, and how you can see your Canvas gradebook. I hope this video was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions.